In this section, we're going to cover the following points: administration of organizational units, adding and removing users, OU security, renaming an OU, and finally, deleting an OU.
Okay, we've signed in, and here is our faithful admin console, which we've discussed in previous videos. So we're going to talk today about organizational units, or an OU. Now, this, to people who are quite long in the tooth in dealing with things like Active Directory, and Exchange, it's 5.5, and other future reiterations of Exchange, will be no stranger to the organizational unit. So in Google Apps, a very similar beast, so to say. So here we go, into users, and here on the left hand side, by organization, we have our top level OU, or top level organization. Now this generally follows the same name as your domain that you register. Below this, you can have as many sub-organizational units as you want, or as few. If you only have one organizational unit, then any settings will apply to your entire organization. If you have multiple organizational units, like I have here, which I've set up during the Google training that I went through, you can install some granularity into what you do. Add users into different organizational units, allow them to have access to different applications. For example, management would have Gmail, YouTube, Drive, but contractors wouldn't have YouTube, but would have Gmail. Okay, so we can be quite granular on how we do this. Users can only be a member of one organizational unit. So for example, in the Let the Wookiee Lose top level OU, I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 users. In the contractors OU, we have no one. What we can do is move. We're going to select him. We're going to click on the link here, move to another organization. We're going to select the contractor's organization and click OK. Go back to the users menu. You can see Tim has disappeared from this group, or this OU, and is now residing in the contractors OU. So let's go through adding a sub-organization. If you click the focus to the right of the top level or main organizational unit, you can see two options appear: add sub-organization or edit organization. Let's add a sub-organization. Let's call it bakery. We'll place this organizational unit under the main OU. However, you can make it a sub-organization of a sub-organization, a sort of a tree effect. This would mean that any permissions or restrictions or applications you assign to that OU would be inherited from the one above, unless you requested it not to, and we'll come on to that in a minute. For ease, we'll make it a child of the main top level OU. create organization. So in the bakery, we're going to add another user. We're going to go to Bill Burton. We're going to move him to another organization, the bakery. Do you want to? Yes, we do. Then, into users, we'll see Bill has disappeared. Click on bakery, and there he is. Take a look at our newly created organizational unit. As we mentioned, it's a child or sub-organizational unit of the top level organizational unit, or OU. If we click on the focus next to the bakery, we get a slightly different menu. We can add a sub-organization to it and give it a child. We can edit the OU, for example, rename it. We can move it to another location, or we can delete it. If we add a sub-organization and call it flower delivery, it'll be placed underneath the bakery OU. Or we can change that if we wanted to. And we'll create that organizational unit. Now you can see on the left hand side it changes, whereas we have our top level, our child, and our child's child. Again, clicking the flower delivery OU gives us the same menu as what we got with bakery. Let's edit this OU. And call it bakery 1. And click save. If we click the focus to the left hand side of the OU and then click flower delivery, we are given the option to move that organization underneath another OU. Let's leave it where it is. Here we are back at our main console screen. So now we have several OUs that have been set up. Let's get to work and add some apps specific for certain OUs. We can do that in the app section. Let's select Google Apps, and we can see on this section the status. Calendar is on for everybody. We can change this, as in on for everyone, on for some organizations, or off. For example, if you had a group of people who were not required to see the company calendar and were casual labor and just came in and filled bags full of flour, for example, then they would not need access to a calendar. You could put them in their own organizational unit, flour baggers, and then remove calendar access for them. So what we're going to do is we're going to remove Google Drive for the flower organizational unit, which sits underneath the Bakery 1 organizational unit. We'll select the Drive application. We'll say on for some organizations. And this will present us with this screen here. On the left-hand side, you can see the organizational unit. Here is Bakery 1. Now Flour sits below it. You'll notice that the master setting and calendar is on for everybody. Bakery 1 sits underneath the Let the Wookiee Loose organizational unit and therefore inherits its settings by default from the parent. If we select flower delivery, then hit override and select off, and then apply, we can then confirm that Google Drive will be turned off for the flower delivery and any sub-organizations. And also, these changes may take 24 hours to propagate. And then click turn off. We also want to do something with Bakery 1. Let's click Bakery 1. Select override. And turn it off. As simple as that. Then turn it back on. Cancel. Okay. So, we can see Google Drive has now been changed to on for everyone to on for selected orgs. For example, if we didn't want them to also to use Talk and Hangouts, we'll go through the same process. Select on for some organizations. This time, we'll select Bakery 1. Override and apply. Let's turn that off. So, turn off Talk and Hangouts for users in Bakery 1. Talk Hangouts will be turned off for Bakery 1 and its sub-organizations. Again, this will mean the flower delivery will not have Google Hangouts. And also, because we took Google Drive away from flower delivery, it won't have Google Hangouts, because that's what its parent has been denied. And then, it has been denied Google Drive itself. Bakery 1 will still have access to Google Drive. So, we've looked at moving individual users into a different OU. What if we want to move several users? We select users. Select the users you want to move to that OU. Select the icon on the top right, move to another organization. Select the organization you want them to move to. Let's say marketing. Confirm you want to move three users to marketing. Click OK. And there they are. And they've gone from the Let the Wookiee Loose parent OU and reside in marketing. One important thing to mention. If you want a user to have specific permissions or restrictions on what they do, right down to the user as opposed to a group of users. As the model states, your user can only be a member of one organizational unit. Create a separate organizational unit for that user and put that user in, and then remove or add the applications or devices on that organizational unit. One other thing to mention as well. Here I am logged in, super administrator. If I select myself and attempt to move myself to another OU, say to management, it will not. You cannot select yourself for a move. Deselect yourself. I would have somebody else, like Alex Bell, log in and move me. And finally in this section, let's deal with deleting an organizational unit. And select users. This time, let's select the flower delivery OU. Now, we have no users in it. An organizational unit will not allow you to delete it if there are users present. Let's demonstrate that. So we will move Bill Burton into the flower delivery OU. Okay. What we've noticed is that you need to refresh the page. There you go. He's moved from Bakery 1. There he is in the flower delivery OU. So, let's try and delete that OU. Are you sure? Okay. You cannot delete this organization because it has users. Big red message. Not to worry. We'll select Bill and we'll move him back up to Bakery 1. Are you sure? Yes, I am. Refresh the screen. So after that screen refresh, we can see that he's been moved back to his Bakery 1 organizational unit. Here we go. And there he is, Bill Burton. So now, where we failed before because there was a user in that OU, we should be able to delete it. Delete organization. Okay. Gone. Sometimes, with the replication of the OU within the system, it may take a short period of time. Please be patient. So things to remember about organizational units. One, users can only be a member of one OU. If you want to have granular settings for one particular user, put that one particular user or group of users in its own OU and apply the settings to that OU. Even if it means one OU for one individual person. A parent has settings applied to it. The child, by default, inherits it, unless you tell it otherwise. You remember we went to apps and we select on for an organization, on for some organizational units, or off. Thanks for watching this section on organizational units. Look out for more videos in this series.
If you like what you see, do me a favor, hit that subscribe button and also check out that notification icon. That'll let you know when I'm putting more videos of Google Apps and other collaboration suites on YouTube. I've been the Collaboration Kernel. See you soon in the next video.